I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
I just try to focus on just being positive and you know, just worry about going out there and doing what I do best. You know, I try not to think about losing or taking an L. You know, that's not really my focus. You know, every day, you know, I tell myself I'm a winner. I was born to be a winner at life, not just in the ring, but I was born to be a winner. So whatever I do, I try to give it 100%, and I try to push myself to the limit. But like Steven said, it's all about taking risk. And I wouldn't be where I'm at if I didn't take risk. So I don't mind putting the 49-0 record on the line. I don't mind, putting everything on the line, for this fight. I feel like it's worth it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, this is the last question, Floyd. One more and we're good to go. Operator, go ahead.
And that question comes from Salvador Rodriguez of ESPN Deportes.
Hello, Floyd. Good afternoon.
Hey, how you doing?
How important is for you make the 50 victory in your career, one more over the Rocky Marciano record?
I don't really try to focus on no other fighter, but I'm appreciative for every fighter, and you know that paved the way for me to be where I'm at. I always talk about I appreciate the legendary fighters, even though this is number 50. This is my 50th fight. You know, that's not really my focus. My focus is to go out there and get the fans an exciting fight. Even though I know this is number 50, and we're constantly talking about Rocky Marciano, I just always like to let the fans and the people know Rocky Marciano is a legend. Rocky Marciano did it his way, and you know, I just like to try to do it the Mayweather way.
Thank you so much, and good luck next August 26th. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Any last closing comments, Floyd, and we will wrap this up.
I just want to say thank you to everybody. I want to say thank you, Leonard. I want to thank Showtime. I want to thank CBS. I want to thank Charlie Swanson. I've got to thank Al Heyman. And I want to thank everybody that called in, all the writers, all the bloggers. Everyone from the MMA world, everybody from the boxing world, everybody from the sports world, I just really want to say thank you. And me and my team, and that's all, we all appreciate you guys. Talk to you later.
Thank you, everybody. See you soon. Thanks, Leonard. Thanks, Steven. Bye-bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our program. You may now disconnect.
Very good, thank you. We've been over to Dublin, to Ireland, to chat to some people who know Conor McGregor and have grown up with him. And a few of them have told us that you were one of his idols. He used to study videos of you, your pull counter and various punches. I wonder, when you've been stood with him, do you see anything of you in him when you've spoken and been a few feet away from each other?
I don't think there's no fighter that's in this, just in, I mean, combat sports period that hasn't, that's in combat sports right now, that hasn't looked at a Floyd Mayweather video or studied a Floyd Mayweather fight. I mean, at least I don't think so, because I think this is the Mayweather era, and I was so dominant in my era. So when a person has been so dominant in his era, I think other fighters are going to pay attention, or other mixed MMA fighters are going to pay attention, because they want to be at that same level, and they want to do the same thing. They want to dominate with ease.
Do you see anything in the character between you and him when you're kind of interacting? Similarities at all?
I mean, not really. I mean, he's a. I mean, of course, I'm huge in boxing, but I'm huge in MMA also. You know, I'm huge in both. what I'm saying? My name is huge in MMA, but I'm, you know, I made a crazy, you know, I made a crazy name in the sport of boxing. But it's crazy that, you know, I've been working so hard throughout the years that I end up having a big name in MMA also. So even though I never competed in the MMA, I'm still a big name in the MMA.
And Stephen Espinoza pointed to something earlier on. He said how you took a big risk early on in your career. Given the point you're both at now, who is taking the bigger risk here?
I truly believe I'm taking a bigger risk. I mean, but it's a big reward for both. But I'm taking a bigger risk. You know, I have the 49-0 record. And, you know, when a fighter has lost before, if he loses again, they say, oh, it's nothing. He lost before. But when a fighter has been dominating for 20-some years, never lost, everything is on the line. My legacy, my boxing record, everything is on the line.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.